Welcome students to my channel Bio World. Today we are going to start the chapter Human Evolution. Now the chapter is divided into two sections. In one section we have to study about the Darwin's theory and Lamarck's theory, and in the second part of the chapter we are going to study about the human ancestor, how they have descended, how they have evolved out till they reached modern man. We need to know about some of our ancestors with their few characteristic features of their body development and growth. So in this video we are going to study about three of them. They are Australopithecus, Homo erectus and Neanderthal. You can see the image that I have done over there. In the book also it is available, and you need to learn the characteristic feature with their facial expression, as identification of the image can be given in the paper. So what is evolution, first of all? So evolution, the word itself means modification or changes or transformation. Biological evolution refers to the cumulative changes that occur in a population over time. That means how they evolve out over the period of time. So it's a gradual transformation into a new one, like modification of their physical outbeing, their growth. You can see a kind of metamorphosis. The feature develops with the interval of time. So the changes are produced at the genetic levels also, as organism genes mutate at a regular interval of time through reproduction, and that passes on to the generation after generation. So the first one is Australopithecus, where you can see I wrote skull and reconstructed head. So there are few characteristic features that you can note it down and you can study. All of them are not there, but we need to study about the characteristic feature, how they developed or how they evolved to the next level. So in Australopithecus, as you can see the picture, the development was, we'll start with the cranial capacity. The capacity was, as they were very early ancestor, so the first one you will find in the book, some of the book they give Dryopithecus, Stramopithecus, but they are not there. We start from Australopithecus. So Australopithecus brain capacity or cranial capacity was 450 to 600 cc. Cc signifies cranial capacity. Face was little prognathous, that is down, the slanting down towards type. Eyebrow has creases. Absence of chin. Chin was not there. Forehead was slanting. The canine were smaller than chimpanzees, but still longer than in human. Pelvis and leg bones will show bipedalism, that means they can walk on 2 feet. That was the most important character. So we need to understand that human ancestor which could do bipedalism. Brow ridges, cranial capacity. So their brow ridges projected over their eyes. So these characters only you have to learn, which I told just now, not all. You have to know about cranial capacity, you have to know about chin, you have to know about face, prognathous type and canines, bipedalism, height, nearly 1.2 meter to 1.5 meter. Next you can see is that I have done here is Homo erectus. Homo erectus is another one which was commonly been discovered from Peking. So they were also known as Peking man, and discovered from the Java, that is African descendant they were. Their cranial capacity were 600 to 700, and though they were known as Peking men, some of the book they write 850 to 1200 cc also. Their face were also prognathous type. Jaws were massive and they had very strong teeth. As you can see, they are evolving in the due course of time. You will find their cranial capacity, their brow ridges, their construction height, and canines become stronger as they are evolving out, they're modifying themselves. Forehead was low set and slanting downward. They had height of 5 feet and the reduction in post canine dentine. So you can see they have evolved from Australopithecus. The next that I have done here is Neanderthal. I would be giving you in between, some of more are there, but in this class we are going to study about these three of them. Now Neanderthals, they had cranial capacity much higher than these two. They had nearly about 1600 cc. They had larger brain than that of human, but of differently organized. They were not modern men, but not too far from modern men. Sloping forehead they had. They had prominent brow ridges, but they lack chin. So the protruding chin is lacking here. Canine teeth without groove. Absolute bipedalism. They were completely walking on 2 feet, like human, modern human is doing. And they had erect posture. And they started losing hair from their body. So these were a few characteristic features that I told about these three of them that you have to mark in the book, and those characters you have to study. All of them are not there, but few, like cranial capacity, height, erect posture, or bent one, canine teeth. These were brow ridges, facial expression, prognathous type and all. These are the few characteristic features that for each of the ancestor we have to study for our examination purpose. Hopefully you would understand that you have to study what here, and further in the next class we'll go to few more ancestor, and then I will jot down how they are arranged serially from Australopithecus till the modern man. Thank you students for watching this video. If you have liked this video, please do like, share, comment and subscribe my channel BioWorld. Thank you.